What's going on, guys? I hope you are all having a great day, a great week, a great spring break. I know some of you spring break is already passed. Some of you, your spring break is right now, and some of you, your spring break is next week or it's coming up. So I just hope you guys all have just a great time. But today, what I want to talk to you about is environment. I want to bring this topic into our discussion. And before I even get started, I want to read you guys a story, if that's okay. Is that okay with you? Can I read a story real quick? Just want to read you a quick story. Behold, a sower went out to sow, and as he was sowing, some seed fell along the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Other seed of the same kind fell on the ground full of rocks where it had not much soil, and at once it sprang up because it had no depth of soil. And when the sun came up, it was scorched, and because it had not taken root, it withered away. Other seed, still of the same kind, fell along thorn plants, and the thistles grew and pressed together and utterly choked and suffocated it, and it yielded no grain. And other seed, still of the same kind, fell into good, well-adapted soil and brought forth grain, growing up and increasing, and yielded up to 30 times as much and 60 times as much and even 100 times as much as what had been sown. Guys, that's from Mark chapter 4, if any of you are actually interested. But this story really caught my attention, guys, and it really got me thinking about environment, because in this situation, there was a seed, and that seed was sown in four different places. It was sown on the concrete, on the pavement. Birds came and they ate it up. It was sown in rocks. It couldn't grow. It couldn't maintain itself because it hadn't taken root. It grew amongst thorns and thistles, and it was choked out, and it wasn't able to grow. And then it was sowed into great, prudent, good ground, and it was able to grow and yield up to 100 times as much. And guys, this is the same exact thing that goes on in the environment in our lives. Where you surround yourselves by, what you surround yourselves with, those are gonna be the things that can help you grow and prune yourself and maintain a standard of excellence that you need. Guys, when I was a junior, I think I was a junior in college, and I lived in a 5-bedroom house with five other guys. So I had four roommates and then one guy that just stayed on our couch. I had the only bedroom that was downstairs. I'm telling you, this was a formula for bad news, guys, because if you know anything about college, people like to drink, people like to party, people like to smoke, people like to do different things that are counterproductive to having an environment that's conducive to studying, that's conducive to anything that you need to do as far as like school is concerned. And so, guys, I had a hard time that semester. I had a hard time that year. It was really tough for me. I was barely getting sleep. I had the only room that was downstairs, so you can imagine people are up 3, 4, 5 in the morning. I'm trying to sleep. I can't sleep, so I'm sleeping in class. This is a large part and a big part of why it took me 5.5 years to graduate college. This was a big part. I did not consider my environment. I lived somewhere where it wasn't conducive to what I was trying to do. It wasn't conducive to my goals. It wasn't helping build me. It wasn't helping me do anything that I needed to do to further my life, guys. So just consider your environment. Think about what you need, where you need it, how you need it to be, so that you can continue to grow and continue to cultivate yourself and continue to move forward. Consider your environment, guys, so you can just continue to move forward. That's all I got. So let's get it. Keep your head above the sky. What's going on, beautiful people? So it's been a pretty full day so far. I've been filming some stuff with Christian all day, summer shredding. He's doing a lot of uploads throughout the week, and so it's just been a lot of fun getting some footage and stuff like that. Just got to Alphalete gym. About to hit a workout with him in a little bit.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah. See each other a lot.
Yeah, ooh. Actually we're at the same place, luckily.
Nice.
So.
What's up, guys?
This is Javon.
What's up, man?
Nice to meet you.
What's your name?
Tyler.
Tyler, Javon, yes. Bro. Nice to meet you.
And nice to meet you, Rebecca.
Rebecca, nice to meet you, Javon.
Yeah. That's about to get this workout in, guys.
About to grab some stuff, grab some headphones, grab some stuff to charge, grab another camera, and then just gonna get to the workout. I don't even wanna waste any time, guys. So Skinny Swole Chronicles coming at ya.
A baller like Pippen, and I never played a sport, so I score. Would you say you like my game? And I deal on it. Would you say that I'm the MVP for you? You got a whole lot of bitch woman. I play full game, got that stitch on me. Don't play no games, don't pretend on me. You gon' start with me, we gon' end on it.
Let me do, baby, all the things I said I wouldn't do, baby. All the things I wouldn't do, do for you.
Up the workout, and it was a really good workout. Really good workout, chest and tries. So that was a good time. Hope you guys enjoyed the edit. Basically, right now I'm at Christian's house, and they're in there playing Madden, waiting my turn. But in the meantime, I'm sitting here and I'm editing Christian's video for tomorrow. This is gonna go up tomorrow. Not really. I don't really need to play too much, right? I just want to show you guys. Just sitting here, and then also going to eat some Chipotle. Got a really big bowl and I couldn't finish it. It was just too much food. So I saved it, gonna finish it now, then I'm gonna finish editing this and then go beat these guys in some Madden, because they're all in there playing Madden. And Frank actually talks a lot of game. He talks a lot of smack. He says he's like number 6 in the world or something like that in Madden, which I find hard to believe. I mean, he just beat Christian 23-0, but that doesn't really say anything to me at all. So, gonna play some of that, gonna eat some of this, and yeah, that's what we're gonna do right now. You got beat, bro?
You got annihilated.
Is he good, Joe?
What?
Is Frank good?
No, it's only like 10 seconds, man.
About to score.
No, he's not good.
You said he's about to score?
Yeah.
Ooh, he's about to score.
He's about to score because I didn't know what I was doing, and I freaking gave him pretty much an onside kick.
All right.
Come on.
Gonna try something different, guys. A little bit of vlog style. This workout, just kind of vlog it. Hitting back, buys, and just trying to get it. So let's get it. Just a little update on that game of Madden we had last night.
Yeah.
Frank got the best of me. I'm not gonna lie, he got the best of me.
You know,
because first of all, I haven't played PS. I'm not even gonna make excuses, but I just want to let you guys know I haven't played PS4 in at least I don't even know how long.
And it
at
showed.
Least a year.
And it showed.
21-7. Not that bad. I think if he, like he says he's like number, he's like 12% in the world. I haven't played PS4 in a long time. I don't know.
Honestly guys, he told me that, I was like, that's BS. And then he skunked me 23-0 by the third quarter.
Yeah, but that doesn't really say much, honestly.
The team.
You don't play Madden, Christian? When's the last time you played Madden?
Bro, if he was for one more touchdown, he got skunked.
But he didn't, because I didn't let him.
Yeah, he made it across the 50 one time. On one
chill
play.
Chill out, that is a lie.
On one play.
That is a lie.
Yeah, your name, are they real or not? Are they real or not?
Can you are tell? They real or no? I'm gonna just say yeah.
Damn, Daniel.
Two words, guys. The competitor.
About to do dumbbell preacher curls.
Okay, why?
Because a lot of people make the mistake of when they do barbell curls, standing barbell curls that is, when they curl, they come too far up. And right here, if you see here, your bicep is resting.
Yeah.
Essentially, it's resting on your hand.
Yeah.
So there's a huge...
There's no tension.
So the way we do it with dumbbell preacher curls is we come all the way down and only come about 3/4 of the way up.
Oh,
so the
damn,
tension is there. Let it stretch. That's it. That's all you need. If you come too far up, you notice there's not much movement here. All the movement is from bottom to three quarters up, and that's it. That's all you need.
Lower.
All the way down. All the way up. There you go. Yeah, right there. That's it.
Just got back home, guys, and got a really good workout in. Really good workout. I feel really good. Everything was really good. And I wasn't gonna vlog this. I don't know why not, but so I figured, why not just vlog this? I'm at home, and the water heater in my mom's house actually went out, and so I'm trying to fix it. I've never been the handyman kind of guy. I'm literally looking at a YouTube video trying to figure everything out. At least I'm trying, you know? At least I'm trying. And so, hold on. So, I'm trying to fix this for my mom. Hopefully we get some hot water going. We'll see if we can get it, man, because I'd rather do this. I mean, if not, then I'm honestly just gonna pay for someone to come and fix it for her if that's the case. But hopefully I can just fix it and then I can have like that sun moment where it's just like, I got you, mom. So I'll update you guys and let you know how it goes. So guys, kind of funny story. I can't fix the water heater. It's not gonna happen. I've literally been at it for, it's about to be 12:45. I've been at it for like 3 hours. I didn't even realize how long I've been doing this. Well, anyway, doesn't matter. The point is that I can't fix it. And I've been working on this event. You guys remember the event I was telling you guys about that I'm trying to do where we have different YouTube people come out and it's just like a vacation, but an event where you get to meet your people, you get to listen to them, talk to them, hang out with them, party with them, you know, just a really fun weekend. I've been working on that weekend and like working up venues and stuff like that. And I set in my phone an alarm to contact Lowe's Hollywood, to contact the Lowe's Hotel in Hollywood. And I think that reminder now is going to be to contact Lowe's Home Improvement here in Katy, Texas tomorrow so I can try to get this water heater thing situated for my mom. So I thought that was just kind of a funny story. So just tying back to the beginning of this video, guys, environment. Again, environment is everything. And not only should you consider your environment, but you gotta protect your environment. And you gotta nourish your environment just as your environment's gonna nourish you. And so that's kind of my deal right now is trying to nourish the environment that protected me and nourish the environment that nourished me. And so it's always important to give back no matter what it is. So guys, gonna conclude this video. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next one.